One of the former president's closest confidants and most trusted aides is now expected to be called as a witness for the prosecution in his hush money trial. That's according to a source familiar with the case. Hope Hicks, of course, served as Trump's campaign press secretary in 2016. She was later the White House communications director. And when she testified behind closed doors to Congress in 2019, she said multiple times that she was never present when Trump and Michael Cohen talked about Stormy Daniels. But in documents from Michael Cohen's federal case, prosecutors believed that Trump had joined a call that Cohen was on with Hope Hicks at the time that Cohen was working to make stories about Trump's alleged affairs go away. In fact, phone records show that multiple calls between Michael Cohen and Hope Hicks, including the day that they learned Stormy Daniels wanted to be paid for her story. And when the Kara McDougal story, the other woman who said she had an affair with Donald Trump, when that first went public, Cohen texted Hicks that it was, quote, getting little to no traction, and she responded to him, quote, same, keep praying, it's working. I want to bring in CNN senior legal analyst and former assistant U.S. attorney Ellie Honig. Ellie, I mean, Hope Hicks has testified before in 2019. She testified with the Mueller investigation, and she's testified to this grand jury that eventually indicted Trump. What do you make of what she could offer to prosecutors?
Well, she's potentially a very powerful witness for prosecutors. First of all, it appears she was part of these crucial conversations when Michael Cohen and Donald Trump were talking about paying off Stormy Daniels and Kara McDougal, and importantly, why? That's one of the key questions here. Were they paying her to silence her in relation to the election or just for personal reasons? Also, she's perfectly situated as a witness for a prosecutor. She's not like Michael Cohen. She hasn't spent her whole life talking negatively about Donald Trump. She hasn't split from Donald Trump. I mean, they've parted ways on some things, but she's still more or less in Trump's camp. And so if you trust her testimony, and we know they have her testimony because they put her in the grand jury, if you trust her testimony as a prosecutor, she could be a game changer.
I mean, she essentially, you're arguing, would have more credibility with a jury because she was someone who was not only in the White House, but left and then came back and was certainly in Trump's good graces. I mean, I can remember when she left the White House, he walked her out in front of all the press, in front of us, to kind of like give her this big goodbye, which a lot of people in the Trump White House did not get.
They don't all get happy going away.
No, it's like the door will hit you on the way out.
Let me count the ways in which Hope Hicks is a better witness than Michael Cohen. Number one, Hope Hicks does not have a perjury conviction or a fraud conviction. She's not lied to Congress. Number two, she apparently is still in decent graces with Donald Trump. You don't have to have her attacked on the stand the way Michael Cohen's going to be attacked as a person who is single-mindedly obsessed with bringing down Donald Trump. She's still in that camp. And number three, she's just more detached than Michael Cohen, and you want detached. As a prosecutor, you want your witnesses to be straight down the middle, just the facts. You don't want people with agendas, with axes to grind. So if I'm looking at the two of them, I would much prefer Hope Hicks. I mean, now, a key question is going to be, does her testimony mutually reinforce or does it contradict?
Well, and the ballgame here is going to be tying Donald Trump to knowing about this, right? I mean, that's how they would be able to effectively make their case. So the question is whether or not she could shed light on that.
Okay, this is such an important point that you've touched on. This is not about, did Donald Trump pay hush money? That's not illegal. This is not about, did Donald Trump know they paid hush money? He pretty clearly did. That's also not illegal. This is about falsification of business records. And so the crucial link that has to be made is that Donald Trump somehow knew about, blessed, ordered, instructed that when you guys log these payments, don't put them in there as hush money payments, put them in there as legal fees. And that's the thing we actually don't know, that I've not seen documents that show Donald Trump knew or ordered that that's how they'd be logged, but that's the crime, falsification.
It's kind of remarkable just looking at all the people who could be called as witnesses, and we expect there to be a pretty long list. It's like a redo of 2016 and the campaign. I mean, Kellyanne Conway testified to the grand jury as well. We don't know if she'll be called to potentially testify. Actually, we don't know for sure that Hope Hicks will. We expect her to. We don't know for sure until it starts, but I mean, it's pretty remarkable who we could see get up there on that witness stand.
Yeah, I mean, we are in all likelihood going to hear from Michael Cohen testifying in a criminal case, Hope Hicks, potentially Stormy Daniels. But it's also important for people to understand there will be boring witnesses, too. Not all witnesses are going
to be documents.
Yes, I mean, the documents, right? You have to call people who can say, yes, that's a ledger. Yes, this is how we kept the ledger, that kind of thing. So, but this is going to be a remarkable trial. We're going to see things playing out from that seem like ancient history. I mean, 2016, if you have a kid in college right now, like I do, they were in elementary school when this all happened.
Don't age us.
Sorry.
What would be the first question that you asked Hope Hicks?
Well,
if you were in that,
that's
if you were in that
great
courtroom?
Question. I would go right to those phone calls where she was on with Donald Trump and Michael Cohen. I would ask her essentially, you can't lead, but if I could lead, I would say, You all made those payments because it was the election. You all made those payments because you were afraid of what her coming out to the public could do to Donald Trump in the 2016 election.
It's remarkable to see what this could look like.
I'm looking forward to it.
I bet you are. I'm sure we'll be covering it all together. Ellie Hoding, thank you for that.
We have a better view of who's likely to be called to the stand to testify against Trump in his hush money trial this month. And they include some of his one-time closest confidants and trusted aides, like bold names from his White House days, Hope Hicks and Kellyanne Conway. CNN's Zach Cohen has much more on this for us. He's joining us now. What more are you learning about this possible witness list, Zach?
Yeah, Kate, the prosecution's witness list in this case, we will see several witnesses that are from Trump's orbit around the time of the 2016 election. That includes people who worked for his campaign team at the time, like you mentioned, Hope Hicks and Kellyanne Conway. But we also expect to hear from people like Michael Cohen, who is Trump's former fixer. He's obviously been deeply involved in this case from the beginning. We expect to hear from Stormy Daniels. She's obviously the porn star who allegedly was paid these hush money payments cover up an alleged affair she had with Donald Trump ahead of the 2016 election. But Hope Hicks is a really interesting potential witness here because of her proximity to Donald Trump at the time. As you mentioned, she is one of Trump's, she was once considered one of Trump's most trusted confidants. And she also was around and can provide insight into what was happening inside Trump's political operation around the time that these payments were allegedly being made. A federal search warrant actually put Hope Hicks on the phone with Michael Cohen and Donald Trump in 2019. Around this time, and the FBI believes that those calls were about Stormy Daniels and about payments to her. So we'll have to see. As you mentioned, this comes as the gag order against Donald Trump in this case has been expanded to include family members of the judge and of the prosecutors. But also remember, too, the gag order applies to witnesses in this case. So we'll have to see if Donald Trump can restrain himself from publicly attacking witnesses, especially ones that were previously very close to him.
Yeah, and we'll see maybe very soon, because often this is happening on the campaign trail, and he's headed back on the campaign trail today. Zach, also, after a lot of back and forth and a lot of wondering what Donald Trump was going to be able to do or pull off, he has now posted a $175 million bond payment. This has to do with the penalty he faces after his civil fraud trial. What happens now?
So the fact that he was able to post this bond means that any action the attorney general in New York can take as far as seizing Trump's assets, that's paused, right? And that's paused until at least September, when Donald Trump will start the appeals process and appeal the verdict in this civil case. But look, I mean, this is effectively a win, as Sarah mentioned earlier, for Donald Trump. It's a significantly reduced amount that he had to post for bond. But we'll have to wait and see. I mean, it is a temporary win, though, win for Donald Trump.
It's good to see you, Zach. Thank you so much for that.